Hi, my name is Justin Quinn, DMS Product Manager for DXOne. I'm excited to be back for our March release highlights and Go Faster Tip of the Month video. Time is precious, and I know you're busy, so let's jump right on in. The first item I'm going to cover was a biggie, the new receipt type window. And so far, reviews have been great, but there's a few things I want to make sure you know. SMS and email fields auto-populate with existing customer records. However, we do allow you to use one-time use cases. When you do use an alternative SMS number or email address, the system will ask you if you want to update the customer record. Just hit yes or no, and you're good to go. We also record all these digital communications in the customer communications records. Just another way for dealers to track accountability and history, and we know this is important. For users who don't want the window to pop up after completing the sale, there is a toggle in the general dealership settings to stop the receipt type window from opening after invoice completion. We now bring you the ability to add a monthly payment price to a unit in any of your listing inventory to show on your website. To add a monthly payment on a unit, select the monthly payment section under pricing, enter the financing terms, and click save. The calculated monthly payment, along with the loan term, interest rate, and down payment, will appear on the unit listing. This should really help your customers find a vehicle in their budget. In this month's release, we also wanted to improve a couple areas of parts reporting. First, we added a brand new report, Open Layaway Parts. Just like it sounds, open this report, see what parts are on layaway, what invoice number is, who the customer is, and how to contact them. Our goal here, to better help you manage your inventory in this area. We also added the rolling 12-month sales totals to the existing min-max report. Our goal here, give you more information to make sure that those min-max levels are matching your sales. And thanks to Jerry at Titlers for this suggestion. I think dealers are really gonna like this. And now, the Go Faster Tip of the Month. This month, I got a couple tips to help you around changing unit information or transferring units out of MU inventory. When entering a unit into inventory and you make an error by accidentally selecting a wrong model, simply click the Change Model button in the unit inventory detail and select the correct model. Hit save and you are good to go. On that note, not all inventory entry errors are model information. And to correct this issue in DXOne, you do need to use the transfer unit out of inventory process. Make sure when transferring units out of inventory, you do not forget to enter a transfer acceptance number as well as a transfer acceptance date. When this is done, the complete button turns blue, becoming active, allowing for completion of this process. I know looking at a lot of dealer data that this step is being overlooked. If you do use the transfer process, I suggest going into the transfer out of inventory window and just make sure units are not sitting there. So those are the March Go Faster Tips of the Month. Hope they help, and I'll see you next month. We'll be right back.